is, anyone would like to ride with me next week up to Tampa, Kansas, we can go up there for the circuit forum. They will be electing a new circuit visitor. Pastor Davis has fulfilled his terms, reached term limits, so that will be next Sunday at 2:30 at Tampa. So I will be going and voting then, so we'll see who the next circuit visitor will be. They'll take over next summer during the district convention. So that is coming up. And then also, we're still doing here our online services. We'll be doing those for a while here yet as well. Coming up in October, I've got one more Sunday when we'll be gone, when we are traveling to Ohio for our daughter's wedding. So that means that one Sunday, the 18th of October, that we won't be here. We'll have a guest pastor, so there will not be an early service that day, just a late service. So you may see some different people here, or there may be more people online on that day for those things coming up. But if you would like to volunteer to help out with anything at the early service, I'm sure the church office will take your time and tell you what we can do for sound or percussion. There's not a whole lot to do in the mornings, but just a little bit. It's kind of like serving here at 10 o'clock then as well. If you'd like to help out with usher or something different like that as well that you haven't done before, we can always get you signed up for something there as well. So let's continue here with our worship this morning with our first hymn, number 869.
Jesus will bring wind, dear.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us then confess our sins to God our Father.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you, our word and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We continue with the introit for today. Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God.
Be gracious to me, O Lord, for to you do I cry all the day.
Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, do I lift up my soul.
Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my plea for grace.
But you, O Lord, are a God merciful and gracious. Turn to me and be gracious to me.
Give your strength to your servant, and save the Son of your maidservant. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God.
Be gracious to me, O Lord, for to you do I cry all the day.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
defend her church. And because she cannot continue in safety without your aid, preserve her forevermore by your help and goodness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah. Arise, go to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow there to feed you. So he arose and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, behold, a widow was there gathering sticks. And he called to her and said, bring me a little water in a vessel, that I may drink. And as she was going to bring it, he called to her and said, bring me a morsel of bread in your hand. And she said, as the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked, only a handful of flour in a jar, and a little oil in a jug. And now I am gathering a couple of sticks that I may go in and prepare it for myself and my son, that we may eat it and die. And Elijah said to her, do not fear. Go and do as you have said, but first make me a little cake of it and bring it to me, and afterward make something for yourself and your son. For thus says the Lord God of Israel, the jar of flour shall not be spent, and the jug of oil shall not be empty until the day that the Lord sends rain upon the earth. And she went and did as Elijah said. And she and her household and he ate for many days. The jar of flour was not spent, neither did the jug of oil become empty, according to the word of the Lord that he spoke by Elijah. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man.
It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
The epistle is from Galatians chapters 5 and 6. If we live by the Spirit, let us also walk by the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking one another, envying one another. Brothers, if anyone is caught in a transgression, you who are spiritual should restore him in a spirit of gentleness. Keep watch on yourself, lest you too be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. For if anyone thinks he is something when he is nothing, he deceives himself. But let each one test his own work, and then his reason to boast will be in himself alone and not in his neighbor. For each will have to bear his own load. One who is taught the word must share all good things with the one who teaches. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever one sows, that will he also reap. For the one who sows to his own flesh will from the flesh reap corruption. But the one who sows to the Spirit will from the Spirit reap eternal life. And let us not grow weary of doing good, for in due season we will reap, if we do not give up. So then, as we have an opportunity, let us do good to everyone, especially to those who are of the household of faith. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Hallelujah, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life.
to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money. Therefore, I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to a span of life? And why are you anxious about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even Solomon, in all his glory, was not arrayed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is alive and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For the Gentiles seek after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated while I sing the sermon.
Our God is exalted.
because they didn't have anything to worry about or anything to have anxiety over about what they should eat or drink or wear. And while that might still be true for children today on those topics, that they don't worry about those things, there are plenty of other things that young people even worry about today. They're concerned about getting the right education to find the right job that they'll do for the rest of their lives. They have anxiety about whether someone likes them enough to go out on a date with them, or whether or not they like them enough to be friends with them. It is difficult to banish all anxiety from the human heart because there are concerns that we have in life, as well as having the devil right there trying to rob our trust in God out of our heart. We cannot allow our everyday needs to overwhelm us, because everyone on earth has a care for what they will eat, what they will drink, what they will wear every day. But don't let your means overcome your faith in Jesus Christ and His excellent daily care. Our text today from Matthew 6 really began with Jesus giving a summary of some of the verses that had just come before our text today about riches, about laying up treasures in heaven, where moth and rust can't destroy, where thieves cannot break in and steal. And then Jesus gives this warning that no one can serve two masters. A person can only be dedicated to one master at one time. This is true yet today. For someone working hard, trying to get a promotion at work, while at the same time maybe they just got married, or they just had a child, or their child has gotten to the age where they've got these different activities and games going on. So that being in an office and being present for their child doesn't fit into the same schedule very well. Thus, Jesus tells us how difficult it is to have two masters, either being devoted to the one or despising the other. And then Jesus gives us the warning about worry and examples about not worrying from creation, the creation that we see all around us. The first example, the birds of the air. They don't plant seeds. They don't harvest. They don't store up any grain for winter. And yet God graciously provides for these creatures day after day. They don't worry. They fly from branch to branch or rooftop to rooftop right outside your bedroom window, and they sing their happy little tune. God has more care for a single human being. There are much more value to him than a great number of birds. So if this is what God does for these birds, then you shouldn't be anxious in your life. Easier said than done, right? But what does your worry do for you? Well, if you're worrying, it might keep you up at night. It might turn your hair gray, or you might lose your hair, right? It doesn't add any benefit to life to worry. Because if it did, then we'd all have smoother skin, right? Less fat around the midsection. Or tallest one in our family because we're the best worrier. So why worry when it doesn't benefit you at all? The second example that Jesus gives from his creation is the flowers. With the weather now turning cold, people are getting close to turning off the sprinklers for their lawns or not watering the flowers that they've planted. Maybe even picking up a few fall plants. If you catch some of those flowers and you bring them into your kitchen, those flowers last for a short time before their beauty fades. Beauty that they had when they were fresh. Why do we plant flowers? Why do we cut them? Why do we bring them inside? They're beautiful. The colors that they have make our hearts glad, kind of like hearing the birds sing then as well. They make our hearts glad until they start dropping those petals on the kitchen table and you gotta start And yet, once again, human beings are much more valuable to God than these beautiful plants. Then Jesus calls the disciples this term that he used a different place in the Bible, where Peter was walking on the water in the midst of the storm, with Jesus walking on the water. But then Peter started slipping into the sea when he took his eyes off of Jesus. And he calls him one of the little faith. They have faith, but it's not focused on God properly like it should be. When our faith is not looking to Jesus Christ alone, like Peter walking on the Sea of Galilee, or sinking, we also begin to sink into the depths of worry and despair and doubt. Get back to the commandments. The very first one says we should have no other gods. When worry about food or clothing or any other need we have causes anxiety in our life, we lose our focus on God. But just like with Peter, Jesus is waiting there for us to call out to him, to save us from our doubt, to bring us back to safety. We're the second command. Don't worry about this earthly life. Because when you do, it makes it seem like God doesn't care about the littlest details in our lives. So that we forget to call upon him in every need. Or to praise his name when he gives us our daily bread. For these sins of not completely trusting in God, we need to confess our worry, our anxiety, to him and lay before him all our needs, and then trust that he will take care of them in the way that he deems to be best for us. That's difficult because sometimes we think we know better than God what we need and what he should give to us. But we know that's not true. We are very, very valuable to God in this creation, more valuable than the birds of the air and the flowers of the fields. But we are not more knowledgeable or more powerful than God. He is the master, and we are his humble servants. In truth, all the blessings that the nations struggle after, they only last for a short time before even they are destroyed by rust or moth or stolen or lost. But there are eternal treasures. Instead of storing up food, lock up the treasure of God's word in your heart by reading, memorizing, meditating on it. Not only are we blessed to own a Bible, many of us have several different Bibles. But do we read them? Do we have a daily devotion? Do we take part in a Bible study? All these help put the focus where it should properly be, on seeking God and his righteousness in Jesus Christ. The righteousness Christ won on the cross for the whole world. The more our faith is fixed on Christ and all that he's done, the more worry and anxiety flees from us. Not only did God create this beautiful world, give us life and the lives of those around us, including family and friends, but God also sent his own dearly beloved Son into this world to save us from sin and eternal death. Jesus didn't own a mansion here on earth as God's son. Sometimes they had very little food around them, Jesus and the disciples. Jesus' goal was to move from village to village, from town to town, teaching people God's word, reminding them of God's faithful promises that were being fulfilled in the person of Jesus Christ. Jesus was the one promised by God to deliver Adam and Eve and all their children from striving after earning God's favor to give them a place in eternity. Jesus perfectly served the Father, obeying his will even to the point of suffering and humiliating death on the cross to pay for your sins. Can you serve such a gracious God and Master alone? With sins. We may try to love God and serve our neighbors with our daily acts of kindness, but we're not able to do it perfectly. Sometimes people still irritate us. There will come times in life when we have difficulty trusting in God and His wisdom for life, especially when sickness or death comes our way. But God does care for us. He has each and every day of our lives written down, planned. He knows every hair of our heads and the number of our days. We simply have to be mindful of our own mortality. And remember that God has given us many good things here on earth, but the greatest blessings He has in store for us await our arrival in paradise, where we will feast at His heavenly banquet table and live forever in His glorious mansion. So yes, don't be anxious or worried, especially worrying about tomorrow. There's enough to do today in life and in service to your neighbor that you don't have to focus on the future. Don't forget to begin and end each day with prayer to God, placing your burdens and cares back into the Father's hands, because He graciously provides all that you need and calms your worries and doubts with the blessed promise of His loving care. Seek God's righteousness for you as it's found in Jesus Christ, His Son. And all the earthly needs that you have and everyone has, your needs will be sufficiently met because your Father knows you need them. Remember that you are much more valuable to Him than even the most industrious birds of the air or the fantastically clothed flowers of the fields. You are His child, called by His name in your baptism. And He provides for you again today in the supper of His Son's body and blood, to forgive all your sins and to bless all your days. Amen. And may the peace that passes all our human understanding keep our hearts and minds through Christ Jesus, our Savior. We stand and confess our faith together using the Nicene Creed.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of His Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day He rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And He will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Heavenly Father, Be gracious to us, your baptized children, for temptations and anxieties surrounding us. Gladden our souls with the good news of your Son's perfect life and sacrificial death for our salvation. Strengthen us in the faith and fill us with your Holy Spirit, that we might trust in you for all things temporal and eternal. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, show us your abundant mercy to all those whom you have called to preach Christ and him crucified. According to your gracious will, grant faithful pastors to all vacant congregations, and restore in service those pastors without a congregation to serve. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, grant opportunities for honest and faithful labor to all, especially to the unemployed, and give to us all contentment and joy as we carry out our daily tasks. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, grant wisdom to the President, the Congress, and the Supreme Court of the United States, the leaders of our states and localities, and to the rulers of the world, that they would seek peace, promote life, and protect the weakest among us. Guard and protect those who serve in our armed forces and emergency services. They may serve with integrity and return home safely. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, give ear to our prayers for the sick, the suffering, the lonely, the depressed, the dying, and all those in any need. Especially if we remember Judy Ulmer, Margie Bernhardt, Rick Gunn, Richard Oswald, Karen Dennett, and Kathy Esau. Be merciful and gracious to them, and strengthen them in their trials. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, grant that all who partake of your Son's body and blood in the fellowship of this altar today would do so in repentance and faith, and to their abundant blessing. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, according to your will and in your time, we call your children to rest from their labors. Receive our thanks for those who have gone before us in the faith, and grant that we who walk as yet by faith may join them in their holy rest, until the day when you raise us incorruptible and immortal. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Surrender to the Lord.
only begotten Son into our flesh, to bear our sin and be our Savior. With repentant joy, we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and his blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and the remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood, as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. You alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." Same way also he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink with all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
bond and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you steadfast in the true faith to life everlasting. For peace.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Kind of a Christmas thing.
Kind of a Christmas thing.
Yeah.